Alrighty. So armadillo cloak it is. I'll put these back over here. I am American. Do I sound English? Faintness? Interesting. I didn't know that. Alright. So we're gonna start working on armadillo cloak here by unbending it. Actually, our paper is. I'm gonna go get more paper. Be right back. Oh, sorry. I didn't put my mic down. So, Faintness, I do not have any Yu-Gi-Oh cards. I played, last time I did anything with Yu-Gi-Oh was when I was with my brother, and we, more often than not, we basically just threw them at each other. And then, that dingling was Faintness following me, so thank you very much. So let's see what color this green is when we line it. Yeah, so it's a very blue, green, teal kind of color. And that's absolutely not what we're going for on armadillo cloak, see? It's not going to work at all. So, I need more blue. Man, I forget how strong that blue is. So that's not really what we're looking for. Or we can. Make green the old school way. Probably work better anyway. Or make green if I said blue, I don't know. See, that's gonna be much closer to the green we're looking for anyway. We need a lot of this yellow in it. Yeah, that's almost exactly the color that we're gonna want. So we're not gonna be able to use my bottle of green, which is fine. Yeah, so this is much better. So while we have that color, let's do a little bit of it for the base. So you don't want it to be perfect. Bit. Right, so I am on camera. This is not the brush I normally use for this. And I'm just doing this little area here because that's where the green on the outside is going to be. It's going to be darker up here, so I can go ahead and black it out with a darker color. And then it'll be lighter down here, so I definitely don't want to have that much green. I've heard of people like actually taking an eraser to the black edges, to the black border of cards, to kind of remove the black border, which doesn't make a lot of sense to me. I pretty much, I just take the card and I take my paint and then I start going to town. Aw, thank you, Bayoui. I mean, this is definitely not the final color green, but it is close enough that it works very well, so it'll work very well as a base coat. I actually have to wait for it to dry when I'm not doing the whole border around the same color. And like I said with my other one, lots and lots of thin layers is the best way to do it. So probably one more layer on that side. Well, no, maybe more than that. I'm just trying to kind of get a uniform darkness from this gold background to the black background area. Yes, that's probably enough. And it's about as much as I had Melek. That out. Some of this blue and more of this yellow. Lovely color. All right. paint and my brush. Do. Okay. So we're gonna try a little bit of that color, I guess. I don't know, I don't really like it. No, I don't like the color. Dang it. Oh, that's better. Hi there, Telemokos. Yeah, I finished Melek. I will show you in just a minute. I'll show it off again. Probably when I finish this black color or black green.
man.
Bye, Bobby Wayne. I'll see you again. Well, probably. I suppose that's up to you. I thought I almost painted on my headset. That would have been really bad. The headsets are unintentional, though. Alter everything? Oh no! That would take forever! Basically just need white. Whoopa. Ugh. It's precious, so much green paint in it. Ugh. I need more water. Oop. guys are silly. Now white. White's gonna take forever to cover. But we'll get there. But yes, Kozluck can alter everything, can't he? Although I think he prefers to call his alters distortions. Hey, freaking Brian, by the way, I thought I saw you earlier. That'd be pretty great. Someone was talking about running it as commander last night. Who was it? I don't know. There's so many people on last night. I don't remember who it was. Make sure you put at least one square somewhere on it so that it's like Kozilek distortionized. Almost there. Doing that's not a bad idea. Since the white's gonna kinda go up that way. No, the green's probably gonna come down though. I don't know. Yes, this is probably going to continue down here, so I didn't need to do that, but that's all right. Won't hurt me to have some extra white underneath where it's going to be relatively light color anyway. Oh, I love that. It's a great idea. Yeah, Kozilek was going through my shit again. Kind of trying to fade into the art there so that I can get a cleaner transition later. Voila, I got the face coat of the top done. Should do black. That's so cute. Birds are adorable. I'm just super allergic to them. Yeah, that's what I think the Innistrad block is gonna be too. We're gonna have Emrakul over at Innistrad. And Avacyn's gonna have to come fight the giant Eldrazi. It'll be great. Use one of my small ones though. And that is how you get paint on your table. So all the shit hit the fan this weekend for Magic, and now there's like nothing new to talk about. Cause before we were all speculating on bans, and then this weekend happened. Huh. It's kind of odd to think about. Alright, Wayne Reynolds, we're getting your name off the card. Sorry about that. A little bit. That's an option. I mean, somehow I'm gonna have to either fade from almost white to black, or the whole thing is gonna have to be light colored, which I guess I could do. Make the whole thing white. Yeah, the whole thing probably would go white. Well, okay, so if I do it white, it'll be easy to turn it black, but if I do it the other way, it won't be. So let's make it white. Dad of Innistrad. Hi there, brain maggot. You're just seeing me get started. I think my favorite planeswalker is Kiora, and not just because she's a merfolk. She's like super badass. She steals the Biden of Thassa, no big deal. Whatevs. Oh, you need this to rule the sea? Cool, I'll take it. Now I can rule the sea. I'll be better at it than you anyway. Did I ever post my picture of me with the big Kiora cutout or poster banner thing at Cincinnati? I don't know if I ever posted that one. Awesome. Good. I was originally really bummed because at GP Pittsburgh they didn't have Kiora anywhere. It made me really sad. But then I found her in Cincinnati, so one more point for Star City Games over PES. Yeah, my mic was off because I didn't feel like sneezing at everybody. So I was saying hi, Revenant, because I don't think I said hi yet. Sure, yeah. Can you pull it up though? Because I don't remember it very well, not having played with it at all or anything. When it enters the battlefield, target opponent reveals their hand. Oh, right! The Vendilion Click. I remember that one. Or Eldrazi click, yeah. Ugh. Click is pretty good. I mean, it's more hand disruption and it's on the creature body, so that's why Vendilion Click is good. You can do hand disruption, basically discard. And Vendilion Click, you have to pick if you're gonna put it on the bottom and let them draw a new card or not. This one, you just take it out and put it away until they manage to deal with it. Which is pretty sweet. So he's a little bit more like Oblivion Stone than Click, maybe, but Oblivion or Oblivion Ring, not Stone. Oblivion Ring from the hand, as opposed to the battlefield. I think Thought Not Seer is going to be a pretty good card. And it goes to exile, so if they then eat it from exile, it won't be in exile anymore, and they won't get it back. Oh no, it's draw a card, never mind. But it puts stuff in exile so that they can, then eat stuff out of exile right away with their processing. Yep, you're right. I just misread A non-land card? Generally, when you play it, you're gonna be able to. You should be able to hit something. So I wouldn't worry too much about them not having targets. think I just ate some paint. Oh yeah, but that'll be really hard to draft. So you only have one pack of Banner for Zendikar, right? And don't you need a card from it? I didn't eat any paint. Altered teeth. I didn't eat the paint on purpose. But yeah, there's some on my paintbrush handle, and then I put it in my mouth, because that's how I hold my paintbrushes sometimes. Because I'm definitely a grown adult. Absolutely a grown adult. Yeah, if you pull off that draft, if you manage to draft that combo, it would be so cool. But yeah, then you have to have the combo. You have to draft all the pieces, then you have to draw all the pieces. Like, it's not exactly realistic. You'll probably draw a whole or draft a whole lot of really bad decks trying to get to there. Nice. I would have loved to gotten to play the Two-Headed Giant pre-release. Just sounded like so much fun. A combo cube? Would be intense because you'd have to draft a combo without letting anyone else draft a combo. Had a blast. That makes more sense than black. Well, okay, you want to see how adult I am? All right, here. I own my house, but I also own A giant pink hippo stuffed animal. Because I'm definitely a grown up. So yes, definitely adult. Nothing wrong with stuffed animals. Nice, all the removal. That probably helped you win. How'd you do? Oh, finals, of course. There you go. Yeah, it is. Well, Felder Griff is purple. Think. Ooh, nice. Very nice job, Reverend. Revenant. Getting tongue-tied. I've been on stream for too long. That's what happens when you like build removal that deck. You were the board control deck. What? That's crazy. You welcome back, Mondragon. Yep, so we just got started on Armadillo Cloak. Well, and by just got started, I mean we've been working on it for like a half an hour or more. Abomb.com? Be careful, because that's probably a link, and I have no idea what that leads to. Yeah, it's probably a link. Don't click on it, guys. Let's see. All right, sorry, Lover Bacon. You have 5 seconds, so you'll be right back. Yep. I got you. What was an innocent comment could have turned out to be something very less innocent. Yeah, that'll probably work better. Congrats, Remnant. I want to know Ewok Slaughter. I'll have to look that one up. Haida Chief. Selena Dark Angel. Do we not go? Can we search for it, please? Internet, why are you not cooperating? Now it's searching. Internet, come out and play. Wow. Are you guys able to see and hear me okay? Maybe it's just being affected because of my upload speed, or my upload. There we go, oh, there it is. It's a pretty card. Three flyer with pay two life to bouncer. Not bad. Not bad card. Oh, if I were a planeswalker, what would my color allegiances? Whatever. What colors would you be? I would be red, red, black, probably. I'm gonna go with that. Red, red, black. I'm not a blue maid. I mean, blue just isn't the color that would describe me. Much darker than you'd expect from me. As for Bug Mardu, Domin Hyphy would be Grixis. Yeah, but I would be Rakdos. Well, I think that card has been whited out. So that's what the bottom of the card is going to look like. The bottom is done. Woohoo! So Esper and Bug together. Two black, white, four loyalty. +1, all opponent's creatures get a -1/-1 counter. That's pretty strong. All of your creatures get a +1/+1 counter for 0. Okay. And get a token that says all of your creatures gain flying and lifelink. For -5? Mm-mm. -7. So you can activate it the fourth turn you're out. You can have all your creatures gain flying and lifelink. But absolutely not at -5. The second turn they're out. Mm-mm. Yeah, I think the abilities are acceptable, but I think the prices are not correct. No, I think it needs to be -7. I mean, the problem with it is that it's a counter, so it stays. And then you'll eventually, the longer that your planeswalker is out, your creature will die. All of their creatures will die. They'll just can't do anything more. Yeah, I think it's until your next turn. So, like, they're weaker on their turn. It's just, like, as long as you do it, they're all down a little bit, and you will wipe all of the little one toughness creatures, and then -1 to give all of your creatures +1/+1 counters, at least, probably -1. I have a +1, a -1, and a -7. That would probably work. And if it's opponent's creatures get -1/-1 till end of turn, that even hits indestructible and hexproof because it's all that kind of stuff. So that's pretty good. Yeah, it's the added negative toughness that makes a big difference. Yeah. I think that's good, Domin Hyphy. I like it. Right. Yeah, four color planeswalker would be really hard to cast. Very much harder than two black white. It's almost 4 o'clock, so I'm not gonna start the next step. But it was fun. I had fun painting all afternoon. You'd be five color for or five color with yeah, like Phyrexian costs. No, that's life. Never mind. With the colorless, whatever. I give up. Right. Yeah, I don't know what my planeswalker abilities would be. Carrick designed me a Merfolk card. It was blue red, I think. No, it's blue blue for a 2/2 merfolk, and you could pay red to give target merfolk haste until end of turn. I thought that was pretty cool. Still wouldn't splash red for it, but he kind of designed that as the me Merfolk or something. Yeah. It's a pretty cool card. Not gonna lie. Alrighty. Right, and yeah, with the tribal restriction, it's not nearly as broken. But they have goblins like that. I mean, goblins are red, so it helps a little. But I don't know. I think it'd be a pretty sweet card. Maybe we'd go in the new blue-red merfolk that was printed or is about to be printed or whatever in Oath. Make a different kind of merfolk deck. But having to attack each turn if able is a significant downside. Yeah, the cantrip on second spell. That merfolk. I like it. Think it's all creatures you control. The downside would be less negative if it was everybody, though. If it truly is all creatures gain haste and must attack each turn if able. Pretty sweet. Alrighty, so my plan. Tomorrow, my plan is to play Legacy tomorrow night. So I guess I'll see you all then. I have to go do laundry. I have the one load went in 4 hours ago, so it needs to be moved over. It's all sitting there soggy and gross. Alrighty, so thank you all for hanging out and watching. Yep, Legacy Merfolk. There's a couple of videos up of me playing Legacy. Yes, I'm going to go adult. Bye, everyone. See you tomorrow.